So right-hand side of your screen, you can see Lotto Destiny. They are the best positioned there. Then we have in the middle of the screen, Israel Premier Tech. Now Astana starting to come forward. Mirku is second in position. So we know Cavendish will be behind him.
It's Ballerini who leads the charge for Astana. John Degenkolb pushing forward for DSM. He's got Jakob Fuglsang sitting directly behind him. Next in line, it is Niels Eekhoff. Niels Eekhoff will have to do the lead out because Degenkolb doing all this work now. He won't have enough left in the tank in the final kilometre.
5 kilometres to go. It's still 2 more kilometres in this same direction. Then there'll be those 2 roundabouts, right-hand turns that Simon showed us in the final kilometres analysis. Matt, finally we see the Alpecin de Kooning team moving to the front. They have been missing in action for the last few K.
There they are in the grey colours, lining up beside Lead Out Trek. And Christophe Laporte on the front, Bridie. He is more interested in protecting Jonas Vingegaard. He is not doing the lead out for Wout van Aert.
Well, Michael Matthews now in this new role as contributing to a lead out, you can see the Jacob Alula squad really wanting to push hard for their rider, Groenewegen.
Oh, and the orange you can see of Luke Durbridge, he's the rider. Shoulders are rolling all over the place. He's trying to move around the outside. He has got Dylan Groenewegen quite a ways back. Groenewegen sits the wheel of Luka Mezgets. 4 kilometres to go. Matthews, Almer Reinders, Durbridge, Mezgets, and Groenewegen. That's the lineup for Jacob Alula. Here comes Intermarché. But again, Bridie, like we saw in Turin, 4 riders from Intermarché, and then Binyam Gourmet on his own, 5 positions further back.
Well, you can see on the left-hand side, though, fantastic positioning from Lotto Destiny. This is what we're looking for Arnaud Delis. We want to see Drizner's Patron through the bunch.
Now Tadej Pogacar on his own, the yellow jersey, is inside the all-important last 4 kilometres. He is playing the game of safety. Stay out of the way of the sprinters.
Brent Van Moor now on your right-hand side. Then you can see Intermarché. Look at the tongue out of Fedorov. He's working really hard for Astana.
It is shoulder to shoulder at the front. And it is the Intermarché team. They're separated. They've got one at the front with Tournesen. No, it's not Tournesen, in fact. This is Kobe Goossens heading towards the front.
And this is all to get to this right-hand turn in the roundabout. You can see how thin the road gets down to one lane. Intermarché, strong, short line there, getting the most out of that corner.
And the race organisation commitment, cutting the roundabout in half, opening the road up.
Well, lead-out men now looking over their shoulder. They want to see who they've got behind them. And this is Drizner's. Australian here, fantastic job.
Cedric Bullens is the rider behind him. It is then Arnaud Delis. Victor Carpenaerts arrives right on time.
The very last right-hand corner now. A little bit more space on that one. Lotto Destiny now at the moment, very well positioned. They still have 3 riders in front of Delis. Right on their wheel, though, Team Astana, and there's Cavendish.
Even though it is the last major corner, it is still a long way to go. 3 riders with 2 kilometres to go at these speeds. It's an enormous task.
Well, they've got Campenaerts, but he doesn't give the guy behind him much of a sit. Look how low he is to the ground. You can also see, well-positioned, the green jersey. That's Abrahamsen, and behind him, Christoph.
So Abrahamsen to do the lead at Astana. They're in a really strong spot. They've still got Ballerini, Case Bol, Mikael Mer, and it's all for Cavendish, hunting for stage win number 35.
Now desperately trying to make up position, it's Sonkra Andersen, the rider from Alpecin de Kooning. He's all in for Philipsen.
And Binyam Gourmet has latched on to another one of the teams, and he's got himself behind Mathieu van der Poel. Gourmet is in contention. He switches on to the wheel of Philipsen. Here comes the red colours of Arkea for Arnaud Demar.
And an early lead out now from the green jersey. Abrahamsen's gone a bit too fast and a little bit too far. Christoph has decided not to go with him.
So DSM, they try to get onto the wheel. Alexander Christoph has slipped into the belly of the sprinters. He's on the wheel of Mark Cavendish. Philipsen flicks out. He's in the black colours with the black helmet. He's behind the world champion Van der Poel in white. Abrahamsen on the front. Astana, they've been caught on the barriers. They need to find a way through. Cavendish is deep in traffic.
Well, so far, Jakobsen in a good position, but it's still too early. 7:50 to go.
Phillipson waits. He's got Bauhaus behind him. Binim Gumay has caught a long way back. Cavendish is in an ideal spot. He gets onto the wheel of Phillipson. Gaviria comes through. He rubs shoulders with Bauhaus. Somehow they stay upright. Now Gaviria is rubbing shoulders with Cavendish. Cavendish wins that battle. Vanderpool tries to squeeze on through. Ryan Gibbons starts, and he starts early. He's got Vandenberg on his wheel. It's Pascal Ackermann in the mix. Cavendish is a chance. He opens up. The hunt is on. He's looking for number 35. The wheels in front. They fall behind. The legend grows bigger. It's history again. Cavendish, number 35. He was already the record holder. He had company. He no longer has company. It's only Cap on top. Here's the sprint. Take us through it.
Well, Cavendish moving around the wheels. He's now sitting there behind the rider from Israel Premier Tech. It's a huge lead out from Ryan Gibbons. Now we see Ackermann accelerate. But Cavendish has a huge amount of space here. Phillipson tries to go across the road and get on the wheel, but he has no match for that velocity. Ample time for Cavendish to celebrate. Second is Phillipson, and it's Christophe Delis. This is the moment we see the crash as well. Look at the movement across the road of Phillipson, desperate to get closer. Demar there in the red jersey of Arkea, but no match for the Manxman.